For Your Entertainment on BCTV is supported by Bonnie Eshelman.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome once again to For Your Entertainment. My name is MZ Hammer, and it's great to be back once again this month. And I'd like to introduce you to a person that was on our show last month, and he never left because he's now part of the show. Eddie Collins, Eddie, what the heck are you doing here tonight?
Thank you, MC. It's a great opportunity to be here, to be with everyone, all of our great viewers, as we constantly showcase local and regional entertainment in all walks of life. And let me tell you something, MZ. When you think about the word magician, you automatically think of a top hat and the tux,
right?
And the guy with the cane and the rabbit comes out of the hat. But we have got a gentleman tonight who is unbelievable because he meshes comedy with magic and illusion.
You talk a good show,
Illusion.
Eddie.
Where is he?
Yeah, you talk a good show. Where in the heck is he?
He must be yourself.
Well, there you are. Oh, hi. I didn't see you there.
KooKoo, the cartoon magician.
Yes, I.
Welcome, KooKoo. Welcome.
Can you tell that I'm KooKoo? No one disputes me on this.
You don't have to convince me.
Allow me to demonstrate. Oh, it's a long story.
Well, it's a long tongue. You understand. They should have seen the look that I had on my face the first time I saw my tongue do that. I couldn't believe my eyes either. I looked something kind of like this. The rest still there. I felt it in there. Do not try that at home. The kids know that. They know that.
Try it in school.
Mm-hmm. What? No, 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 no. Never do that anywhere, any of you. Especially you, sir.
Yes.
You enforce that.
KooKoo, what is exactly, it's great to see you, but what exactly is a cartoon magician? Explain a little bit how that's different from a...
That's a good question. Actually, this brings me to a lot of philosophical perspectives I have on magic and cartoons. I'm trying to remember who it was that was credited by saying, I think it was Arthur C. Clarke, the British science fiction author.
Okay.
He said that any advanced form of technology is indistinguishable from magic. So the earliest films and cartoons and stuff, the people that were making those were actually magicians.
Okay.
They were utilizing things like, you know, those little circles that would spin, you look through the slot and you see a horse galloping. The first people to see those, they were seeing magic, basically. You know, that was their perspective on it. So I kind of look back, I'm reverse engineering all that, and I try to recreate things you see happening in cartoons using magic methods.
Okay, great. And how did you get started as far as this line of work?
Well, you know, before I answer that question,
right?
You know, we're going to have a lot of discussions, a lot of magical demonstrations. But before I commit myself to any sort of mentally taxing tasks, I have to warm up my thinking cap. If you don't mind.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
Pardon me. I'm going to advance toward the camera. Oh. Hi, Mom. That's my mom operating the camera. But see here. It's a little windy here in the television studio, but I think we can do it. Ooh, not bad, right? Huh? This is so weird. I thought I had a...
Moment of truth. Drum roll, please. On your knees.
Here we go, people. Can you see up here? Can you see up here?
Thank you. Thank you.
It appears as though this thinking cap is about
warmed up. Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, too kind, really. Actually, there are three of a kind. There's three cameras. These cameras are very kind.
KooKoo, but what pulled you back to revert to greats like the Three Stooges, the Marx Brothers, Jerry Lewis? I mean, you're kind of... them all rolled in one.
Were they
great inspirations? Was this in your household, or were you just going back to see what was happening early on?
That's the highest compliment I've ever been paid. that whole list of people all rolled into one.
It's true.
To go back to cartoons, I would actually say Three Stooges very much are a cartoon act.
Right.
You know,
right.
That's kind of exactly what I'm doing right there. Syncing things up with sound effects to add punctuation and comedy. But yeah, definitely there were some VHS tapes floating around of pretty much all of those actually just mentioned. They definitely subconsciously are big influencers.
And that's since you're a child, you wanted to do that?
Even as a kid, not necessarily wanted to do the act. Well, you know, that's actually a funny question, because as a small child, I would watch Jim Carrey, Robin Williams, and I'd say, I want to do that, I can't do that. You know what I mean? Because I'd never, in show business, I just assumed you had to be an A-list.
Right.
That's the only way you could be in show business. I never realized you could be a small business in show business.
KooKoo, we have a home viewer already, okay? Ooh. Home viewer, come on in. You're on 4-Year Entertainment. Hello?
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 Yes.
Come on in.
Yeah.
You're on the air.
How you doing?
Great. Who are we speaking to?
My name is James Mahoney.
What's your question for KooKoo?
Is this the wrong number? Yes, my refrigerator is running. Thank you.
That was a silent question.
Yeah, they may call back.
Back to
your question. Also, did I answer yours sufficiently?
Yes, you did.
Oh, very good. I had to warm up my brain to even prepare myself. Yes, that is true. But you did go more to the roots, even further back than I even thought myself before. But also, I went to art school, so that's where I learned, you know, the craft of making different props and things like that. I wasn't even
a magician. And all intertwines together, too?
Exactly. Yeah, it paid off eventually. that's where I met my wife.
Okay.
And she was a glassblower there. She actually works at Albright right now.
All right.
She's
the, right across the street.
Yeah, she works here. The art gallery here. Yeah.
Okay.
But she was into clowning, so that kind of got me. I kind of actually accompanied her. We went to a clown camp together. She was the one that attended. I just stayed in the hotel
room.
There's
a clown.
She went to clown
camp.
Yes, this is. It was in
Iowa. Eddie, did you know there was a clown camp?
I never knew it. I know now.
I wasn't even planning this plug. Priscilla Mooseberger Clown Camp. It's like a 1-week clown college. It's like an intensive thing. But yeah, that was kind of an influence of me there, just spending time with her. And then after I got out of art school, I was just working a job, and it was kind of boring. People weren't coming up. So I found a dollar snatcher. I actually happened to have a modified version of one here. If you're not familiar, you can set a dollar out and say, is that your dollar? Or better yet, here's the tip. Work on your reflexes. It's a money magnet. But yeah, it's a string on a reel. I've made this one to make it more cartoon-themed with a cartoon magnet.
I love the Acme.
Yeah, this is kind of my cartoon spin on it. This is actually the thing that got me started interacting with people doing magic, because people saw the dollar coming up, and they thought it was a magic trick, which at that point I wasn't presenting it as one. It was just kind of a way to interact. They came back to see more and had to keep learning. So that's what kind of got me started on that whole path of really performing.
Watching a lot of your videos, what I notice is that you're very comfortable, no matter what the situation is, if it's an adult or a child, you can interact and you know your audience.
Well, thank you. That's another high.
And it's very important. It's very important.
Yeah. Well, I will say that innately, the energy from cartoons is something that kids can relate to.
Right.
But the classic cartoons are my real influences, so it really is the adults that get the references. People ask me, do you also perform for adults? And the answer is yes, they're the only ones that really know what Acme is. There are some impressive intellectual children that do catch me off guard.
And children with special needs, they love this kind of stuff. Is that what you also do?
Not only that, I was a child with special needs in a sense.
Okay.
I went to Delaware Valley Friends School, which is a school for, that's where I went for high school,
mm-hmm.
School for if you have learning differences and things like that. I had ADD growing up. So, you know, it's kind of a culture that I'm very accustomed to. But yeah, my biggest fan in the world who comes to see me every week, he is on the spectrum himself. And Henry, if you're watching, he comes every single Monday night to see me in a restaurant perform for the past 6.5 years. And there was, let me tell you this, there was 1 week where he saw me 5 times.
That's scary.
I'm impressed, though. I'm impressed. Scary in a good way.
You might rub off on him.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, he might be my understudy. Who knows? He actually does. He does deliver my punchlines.
Talk about the restaurants. How did the Applebee chain come your way?
Well, I kind of came their way, because during that time where I was in the mall studying, I was actually that first job I was talking about was in a mall. I was studying magic, going through forums where other magicians discuss things, and I learned about restaurant magic.
Okay.
So kind of, I translated what I was was doing there to something that would could bring people to restaurants and create an atmosphere there. And so I approached, I think Applebee's, the one in Audubon, the one that I would normally be at tonight, Tuesday nights, 6 to 8, Applebee's Audubon. That was my first one, and I've been at that one and the one in Exeter for almost 7 years now.
It's kind of an interesting concept to eat and have a show at the same time.
Right, yeah. Right.
We have a caller, don't we?
Home viewer?
How you doing?
Is this James?
No, this is Jeffrey.
Not Jeffrey.
Oh, hi, Jeffrey.
No, this is Jeffrey.
What is your question?
How are you doing today?
What is your question, Jeffrey?
How are you doing today? What is your question? Do you like Subway? And do you believe that rabbit's feet are good?
Yes, I do have Prince Albert in the can. This is what happens when you bring on my act. Yeah. This is the calls we generate. I love it, though.
I like the refrigerator running better.
Right. Another high compliment. I'll take it. Thank you.
Do we have I'd like to bring up that crazy car of yours that you drive
around.
Yeah,
it looks like the Brady Bunch vehicle.
Do we have that video of the car, of the automobile that a KooKoo drives in? Can you bring up that video? There it is.
There we go.
Okay.
That's got to turn a lot of heads. KooKoo, what kind of car is that? Is it a Ford Chevy or what is that car?
That's a good question. Well, I like to say it's an Acme Mobile, but underneath all of that facade, it is a Crown Victoria. It is a Ford.
Now, it's a Ford.
A Ford Crown Victoria. People ask me what year it is. It's a 90.
Wow.
BC.
Last millennium, right?
Actually, underneath the hood, though, all the important parts are brand new. Uh-huh. I've replaced all of that over time.
It has to cause a scene going down the street. Somebody does not know that car.
Oh, my God.
The big stick of dynamite up on top. You know, the kids must go, what is this?
The show begins well before the show begins. Driving in a car like that, when you're on the highway, you're on stage. I have to be goofy as soon as I leave the house. People know who I am and what I'm doing, basically, as soon as they see that rocket. Yeah.
Is there anything else you can perform?
That's a good point. Yes. In fact, I was told maybe there's someone in the house that could assist me with something. This is exciting.
I might have someone here for you, KooKoo.
I'll meet you out here.
Why, it's my lovely wife, Suzanne, is going to volunteer for us tonight.
Suzanne, everyone, this is very exciting. Will you face the at-home audience? Oh, thank you. You see, this is my bucket. I'd like you to take the two handles and keep the bucket against your chest. Perfect, Suzanne! Now, Suzanne, have you had your ear checked lately? Okay, she answered quickly. She can hear quite well. This is not like the doctor. This should be more clinical, more entertaining.
I hope.
May I check your ear?
How come she don't hear me, KooKoo, when I talk to her?
Oh. Okay, this might be why.
It's earwax.
I'm so sorry. That's not what I was going for. I will try that again. Let's see what you have here. Suzanne. That's a big one. Wow. Do you have another one? Let me see what you have here. She is loaded. How many has she had? She really is loaded, isn't she? Now, you're pretty close to Suzanne. Yeah, she is your lawyer.
Close.
She's your lawyer?
Yeah.
She plays the fifth. She's my comment on this.
She's my wife first, then lawyer.
Oh, I see. It's a family practice. Well, I know what you're thinking about your lawyer here. You're thinking that was kind of eerie. Baruch. We don't need to use ears. What if instead I could reach up into the air and pluck coins out of thin air? They're all over. There's one right here. There's another one right over up there. And I'd never forget about that one right there. Now, some people think I cheat when I do this. Mainly Suzanne. I don't blame you, miss. I probably do cheat, but I don't know how. I'm just glad it works. You know what I mean? Woohoo! You see this one back here? Literally. This one, right here. Some people think I used to. They're right. There's a second one right over there, but I don't stop at two. I stop at nothing.
They keep coming.
You're actually going to hear the next one, especially Suzanne. Let's face it, this woman just had her ear checked moments ago. Listen! You hear that? There's actually a couple of them right there. But I'll be honest, there's more than a couple. There's a whole bunch. You see, there's another and another and another and another and another and another. Look at that. Another one right there. That's called close-up magic. For obvious reasons, yes. Now, if I were feeling greedy, I'd actually reach up here and grab a whole handful, just like that. Wouldn't that be cool if I could do that? I will admit that. Well, Suzanne, face the people right here, because I cannot help but notice, miss, that you are a millionaire.
We got a dollar behind the counter, a little elbow grease, a little bit on this, a little right there, some right over here, some right there. And Suzanne, let me step around you here.
Wait a second now, this is kind of strange here. She came up with that off the top of her head. I'm impressed. Suzanne, if you will please, I'd like you to cup your two hands out in front of you. Pour every last one of those coins into the hand. Put them together in one hand. I'd like you to use your empty hand to imagine grabbing a coin out of the air. Imagine dropping the coin into the bucket.
She's done this before.
Oh, boy. Suzanne, take this real quick. Now, do you feel a little tingling in your nose? Keep the bucket against your chest, Suzanne. And I'd just like you to blow.
A big round of applause for Suzanne!
Wait, I'm going to take one step further. I know we're running short on time. But real quick, there's a saying, a penny saved is a penny earned that looks like this. That brings whole new meaning to that expression. But I don't like the penny. I prefer the half.
Dollar.
Blah! She looks like she sees this kind of thing every day.
I don't blame you, Suzanne.
But for the sake of brevity, I'm going to do a different ending to this trick. Real quick, I'm going to find one last coin. Suzanne, face the people at home. We started this whole thing off where I was checking your ear, yes? I'm going to check it again, but I'm going to delve even more deeply this time. Okay, so let me see here, Suzanne. Ear went. Sorry, I'm going to try this again and...
Wow. Suzanne, I'm scared of you.
Thank you, thank you.
Fine. Thank you for your help, Suzanne. Thank you.
The great KooKoo, the cartoon magician.
All right.
Fabulous man. We know you've got some shows coming up. Let's pluck a couple of things you got coming up here.
Absolutely.
Show-wise, and give your website. That we know that there's a lot of things happening there.
Did I already hit all three restaurants I do every week?
I don't know.
In case I did not.
Let's go back.
These are all from 6 to 8, each of these nights.
Okay.
Monday night, I'm in this county here at Applebee's Exeter. Tuesday night, I'm in Applebee's Audubon. And Thursday night, I'm in Applebee's Pottstown. All of those are from 6 to 8, free magic at your tableside. And I guess an important upcoming one, this Friday, also another local thing, for those of you who are watching locally, is at the Mingus Magic Shop is their annual Magic Till Midnight. It's a Halloween event. It's located at 528
Lancaster Avenue.
That's the one in Reading, PA. So if you show up there around 5:30, you can actually see, for free entry, a new magic act.
Free.
A 15-minute magic act every half hour, and it's free. It is free. So that's the main one I wanted to get in there. Yeah.
And you're going to be there too.
And I will be, yes, I'm going on at 9 o'clock. Exactly. Now, I'm thinking, do we have time to squeeze in the last little
thing? Go ahead.
Should we try this?
Yeah, let's go.
We always cut it short if we have to. Is your wife still available?
Yeah.
Where is she?
Where is she at?
We've lost her. That's okay. I'll work with you guys. Now, at-home audience, I just want to say I am going to use a marker. Do not sniff markers. Never, ever take a marker and... do not try that at home. Try that at work. No. Never do that. That'd be so bad. What I am going to do is I'm actually going to attempt to create a character of sorts. So hold still, sir. I'm going to kind of capture your essence. Work it, yes, okay. He's done this before.
I've been
here. He's been known to ham it up
he's
a little bit.
I've been here before, there. That's all I'm trying to say. This is coming out very nicely, but this is not going to be you. This is going to be
you.
Yeah.
Now, don't be self-conscious.
Everyone, look at this man. Oh, but we're going to just jump right into this. No, it's not going to be you. Besides, he's a TV host. He's used to that. This is going to be a character for you, okay?
Okay.
Now, I'll let you see my artistic process. It starts off a little sketchy. This is it right here. I know it looks like eggs and bacon, okay? It's going to get better. I'm going to develop this character and bring it to life. And I don't mean that literally, just figuratively. Some people find my art to be quite moving. And I don't mean literally moving. I mean emotionally. Moving.
Wow. Look at that.
But you're looking at it like it's alive. Is everything okay? Are you alive?
What? I can't hear you.
Are you alive?
I still can't hear you.
Are you alive?
Give me some ears.
Oh, ears. Okay, no wonder you can't hear. You need ears. Here you go. Can you hear me now?
I can't hear you.
I forgot the ear holes. That's an important detail. I'm so sorry, sir. Is that better? Can you hear me now?
Oh, that's much better. I can hear you now. Give me some hair.
Well, listen, we might have to cut this yeah. short, though. Let me see. Here we go.
That's do I look handsome?
That is...
How about a nose?
That's what you call Facebook, right?
Yes, you do.
A
big Facebook.
Oh,
no,
P, you.
You
stink.
Everyone's a critic. The nerve of some drawings. Well, I'll tell you what. I'll let you do your sign.
Yeah, KooKoo, it's already... Time's up already. We had a blast. Eddie, it's about time. We're ready to say goodbye, so...
It's been a great time, a great night. Watch KooKoo at Applebee's and all the great shows coming up. Find him on Facebook and his website as well. Your website, real quick?
Is kookoomagic.wix.com/thecartoonmagician. But all over social media, just go to at KooKoo Magic. KooKoo spelled KooKoo. And here you go, guys. As I said, this is a character for you. So here you go.
With that, MC Hammer.
Yes.
I'm Eddie Collins. We'll see you next time. Good night, everybody.
Welcome here, Eddie.
Thank you.
For Your Entertainment on BCTV is supported by Bonnie Eshelman.